Now, I'm pretty sure you may have seen these nanometer scales being shown off on various processors to indicate that this processor is better than the rest. The idea is that the lower the nanometer number, the better that processor is, right? Well, it's not really true. In fact, it's become a marketing term now. I'll explain. You see, when companies say a nanometer scale, it actually means two things. Initially, it meant the actual transistor size, like the amount of transistors that are on the processor itself that do the actual logical transactions. So naturally, a smaller number would mean the transistors are smaller, so more of them can fit on that die, and they can perform complex operations without consuming too much power because they are super tiny. That makes sense. But there's another nanometer scale as well, and that's regarding manufacturing process. And that's what you need to look for whenever a company advertises nanometers. Are they talking about manufacturing process, or are they talking about the actual transistors? Some companies will straight up tell you exactly how many transistors there are in a new chipset. I mean, even Apple shows that. Which is surprising because Apple isn't known to be showing specs, right? But some companies sneakily say, we have a 5 nanometer manufacturing process. Manufacturing process, not the actual die itself. Meaning that the transistors themselves aren't that small. Which means in real world, it doesn't have that big of a performance difference or efficiency gains. Understood? That's the marketing aspect. And even though Moore's law says that the number of transistors doubles every 2 years, I believe we may be hitting a plateau soon because we are reaching the limits of what we can do with our current machinery. You'll either have to shrink the transistors as much as you can, or make the die bigger, or provide more voltage to them so they can perform better. And most companies, including Apple, does a combination of these three things, sometimes two of them. Quinn Nelson from Snazzy Labs has made a pretty good video talking about the M-series chips. You should go and watch that, but the bottom line is, you can't trust nanometer scales anymore. Then what should you look for? Some publications say you can look for transistor density, but upon further investigation, no, it doesn't seem like that's a good factor either. What makes sense to me is looking for architecture changes. Like for example, Apple's new M-series chips, they use ARM architecture, which is different than say Intel's x86 platform. It uses RISC instead of CISC, which is like a computational model. And you can see that the RISC model has much lower complexity involved in it. It doesn't have as much overhead as the x86 platform. As a result, RISC-based platforms, or whichever platform that uses ARM, like your smartphone, it's significantly more efficient and faster. Haven't you noticed, like when you press the power button on your phone, instantly it comes back to life, whereas your laptop may take several seconds to wake from sleep. Why is that? It depends on a lot of things. Mainly it comes down to integration level features. Like your phone is an all-in-one system, right? It's an SoC, system on chip. It's an entire platform, RAM, processor, storage, everything in one chip, whereas your laptop and your desktop PCs are just a combination of things. And the platform is different, therefore, despite having higher power, efficiency may be a different story. So that's what you need to look for, like which architecture is performing better and how is it better. The nanometer size doesn't matter, transistor density and all that doesn't matter because we are almost at the peak of what we can achieve. We are having to combine multiple dies now to get a bigger processor. I mean, that's what Apple did with their Ultra series chips. And the performance is ludicrous. It's crazy fast. I hope the rest of the industry picks up on this instead of using the nanometers for marketing.